one in you. They used to, the carpenter would be in the temple and all the children would go into my big bedroom and they'd all be on the big bed. And we thought they were all going to sleep. They were working with the rules. How to kill the people off and get their children. That wasn't my dream. No. I don't know. So I'm not gone yet.
I'm also a bit unlikely to practice one of the things that I'm also
that man needs ballet shoes.
My memory of it was we had an angel shrine and then where the circle was and the lily was on the other side where the circle was. So as a 6-8 year old one, I couldn't remember because I couldn't be an angel shrine. And angelic magic was a big part. And my favourite witches were the ones who had to go to the angelic training and then embroider their white robes and write in their books and study. Is angelic magic still a thing?
Is it still a thing?
Yes.
I was never very good at it. How it came about, Madeline Montalban, Alex was in Rex Hill and he lived in a house that Betty Britton had, and she was a student of the Andre, student of Madeline Montalban. Alex and Madeline had contact, very brief. I think they were wary of one another. Anyway, Dave and I knew that Alex had all the notes, the angelic. And so I phoned Alex up and said, you know, I like the angelic. Curious, I want to know what it's all about. He said, well, it will cost you the big candlesticks and the incense burners. So Dave and I went down and came back with all this written stuff. Madeline. I didn't know Madeline. We used to read her write-up every month in the dictionary. And anyway, we got it, and it was full of waffle. So we took up like 2 years going through this, deciding, getting the energy, getting the body. And so we started to teach it. Once we experimented it and got the results. Maya was always quite interested. Sort of had a little bit of mathematics about it, that discipline of mind, which didn't suit me very well. Anyway, we had this, and it was put to the group, would you like to learn the angelic? So those that wanted to would come, and they'd take, like all the things that happen in Collins that are done through dictation, and it's a this is speaking into the air, taking out of the air, putting into the mind, bringing it through the body, and earth and the body. So it's a lot of discipline, whether it's the angelic, whatever the system is, it's discipline. And that's probably what we liked about it, was the discipline of those students that took the angelic system. It was a strange thing, because we'd been doing the angelic system a year, and I got a phone call, and it was from Madeline Montalban. And she said, I need some witch magic. Well, this was a woman that was my heroine. She created this angelic system. So I said, okay. She said, well, come out and have dinner. I said, well, I'm not coming on my own. I'm bringing David with me. Well, you never know with these magic. And so we went down there and we were waiting for it to come out because she had a fixation, I think it was on Richard III, and these beautiful paintings with gems that she'd stuck on, and she called them gems of Yeah. And that leaned against this thing next to the fireplace. Well, suddenly the whole thing fell down. I thought it was just wood. But it wasn't, it was all an illusion. And there was David and I picking this illusion up, getting it back in place before Madeline came. Which she didn't really manage to do. And she said, oh, we're not having dinner tonight, and the tea were up. Well, David was one of those occult students, but never, he was a blessing to a teacher. He never stopped asking questions, which is fine if you were his teacher, but if you were Madeline. So we're out and we're having dinner, and she started to pile food onto David's plate. And I thought, what on earth is she doing? And it was to shut him up. Anyway, we drank copious amounts of wine. It was a really strange place that she lived. We went up in this antiquated lift. And as it went up, it sort of jolted. And first time we went, there were these feet and this evening gown. And then we went up to this lady that we could see through the bars. But it was a jolt. And it was a bit of a spirit, you know. Practice. Anyway, after dinner, we went back to Madeline's, and she could take her wine. David would not stop asking questions. All she wanted to do was ask me for some witch magic. She was an angelic practitioner. She wasn't a witch. Not going to tell you what the magic was. Not this time. Anyway, David wouldn't shut up asking questions. She said, right. In your past life, you were a kamikaze pilot. Get down here, I'm going to make you see it. David lay flat on the floor, and she took hold of his luscious red hair and went. In 5 years, something from a great height is going to fall on you, and you will die. You shall tell. We had a wonderful conversation. She was a client had gone to her, and her boyfriend, and then signed. She said to him, "I'll do anything to get him back, anything." And she said, "Really?" So I said, "Well, okay, I'll get your boyfriend back. It'll cost you." And in those days, this was a lot of money. She had lots of money. And Madeline was quite right. What the woman wanted, she had. It wasn't about that at all. She kept it out. She taught Madeline to put money in that. Magic cannot be bought. It cannot.